Saturday evening to all of you. I hope you enjoyed your Saturday because it's going to be the calmest day we have for quite some time, I think. Gray is going to be here to stay. We're getting a few breaks in the clouds across northeastern Wisconsin right now, and we may see some stars out briefly, but the clouds will rapidly increase again overnight in advance of the next weather system, which will produce a little bit of snow soon. Now, this is not the big snow that everybody's going to be talking about. I think tomorrow morning we could see just a trace to a few tenths of an inch, certainly less than an inch across most of northeastern Wisconsin. And then cold air coming in behind that barn burner of a storm that's on the way. I think once we get that heavy snow out of the way across parts of our viewing area, we'll see well below average temperatures by the middle and end of next week. Outside right now, not so bad for this time of year, this time of the evening. 35 degrees at Austin Straubel Field. The wind's out of that chilly direction, though, the west northwest at 8 miles an hour. And elsewhere across northeastern Wisconsin, temperatures holding generally in the low to mid 30s. It is freezing right now in Clintonville. Good evening to you fine folks joining us there. A degree better in Shawano, 35 in Oconto, and also at Austin Straubel Field, as I just mentioned, a degree better from Oshkosh through Fond du Lac, and just slightly warmer for Manitowoc's Lakeshore down through Sheboygan at 37 degrees. Door Peninsula, similar temperatures as well. Now the winds, which were very blustery earlier, are gradually subsiding somewhat. Still a dozen miles an hour in Sheboygan, but most locations generally about 5 to 10 miles an hour out of the west northwest. Temperatures up to the north, chillier than we see around here, 26 degrees in International Falls, Minnesota. That is just the beginning of the cold air, which is locked up in Canada. That's going to spiral down through our area into northeastern Wisconsin. I think certainly late Tuesday and into Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, we'll see a huge cold snap on the way. Satellite and radar combination showing that northwest flow. We get that disturbance out of the way from last night, early morning hours here. There's that thin little break in the clouds that may allow us to see some stars, but the next disturbance up to our northwest from the Dakotas into Minnesota is going to skirt by northeastern and southeastern Wisconsin as we go overnight tonight, mainly after 3 a.m. and then into tomorrow morning. For us in northeastern Wisconsin, it means a potential of some light snow. Here's that precision cast computer model showing you the snow coming in from the northwest as we approach tomorrow morning. It could produce that mix of precipitation, more likely to see kind of a rain snow mix toward the Fox Cities, but around Green Bay, northeastern Wisconsin, better chance of seeing that snow. And then midday, we get a bit of a break from the clouds before they quickly fill right back in advance of that next huge potential snowfall across northern Wisconsin. Here's again the way the computer models are adding it up, and it is dramatic as we approach a Monday late into Tuesday. Look how it just adds up just to our north and northwest. More than a foot of snow possible from Wausau to Rhinelander. Again around here, several inches of snow likely. Tomorrow, traveling around the Badger State, temperature is not bad, rather seasonal, just a few degrees below with that a slight chance of precipitation. For tonight, mostly cloudy, light snow late, down to 28. For tomorrow, on our Sunday, the snow to a snow mix early, about 40 degrees for a breezy high temperature with breaks of sun developing midday. And here is your precision 10-day forecast. Get ready then for the barn burner. Late Monday into Tuesday, the snow starts piling up, and on the back end of it, the temperatures plummet. High temperatures by Thursday and Friday only in the low to mid 20s. What month is this?